celebration of International Women's Day, internationally recognized on March 8th every year since 1914. Our festival is an opportunity to celebrate the gains women have made worldwide. We also encourage you to think beyond today and ask yourself, what are you doing to promote gender equity? What steps are you taking to continuously improve your knowledge of gender issues? Because while this festival is a celebration, it's also about igniting action and passion to learn more about the status of women worldwide. While women can legally run for political office, the United States ranks 75th worldwide in women's representation. Worldwide, women only hold 22% of national parliamentary seats. Women are still underrepresented in the media, including as news anchors. And sadly, even though we have a successful rise of some news anchors, such as Megyn Kelly on Fox News, we still hear comments that her questions and news coverage might be based on the fact that she's menstruating. When we think of what we can do to support gender equity in our world, we also need to think about how we can empower women who are faced with not just sexism, but racism, homophobia, transphobia, classism, ableism, and all the other systems of oppression. For example, in the United States, women make on average 79 cents to their male counterparts. But the picture is actually a lot more complicated than that. There's a greater disparity for women of color, with Hispanic or Latina women earning 54% of white men's earnings. Change is possible. With all of you here taking action, change is inevitable. And despite the current issues we face, we today see improvement from yesterday. We are making progress in new and exciting ways. We are challenging areas of discrimination, taking to online platforms to make our voices heard, and seeing substantial change. This festival is a call to action, a call to think and not be complacent, and a call for us to re-energize ourselves as we continue to fight inequality in our society and in our world. Please join me in welcoming our MCs to the stage, Zamzam Abijama and Monica Hatfield-Price.
Hello. Assalamu alaikum and skawran, as they say in Somali. My name is Zamzam Jema, and I'm a second year doctoral student here at Ohio University through the School of Communication Studies. My area of interest is really about stories and how stories can relate voices of empowerment and self-efficacy. I like stories particularly because I'm Somali, which is an oral culture, but also I'm Texan. Y'all, Texans like to talk. A wise man once said, I don't know, go ask a woman. It's funny because the term wise was only found between the words a and man, and the absence of it between a and woman was profound. We need spaces in which we can talk and celebrate with each other and realize that we don't have to fight the man against the woman, that we can coexist equally in such a space. A wise society said multiple times, I know, for I have asked and respected a woman.
Thank you for being part of the 2016 International Women's Day Festival. My name is Monica Hatfield-Price. I'm a doctoral candidate in higher education from the Patton College of Education. How many of you have been to the International Women's Day Festival before? Oh, yay! Welcome back. Let's get this festival started. It's my pleasure to introduce our first performer today, Lois Whaley. Lois is an Athens area resident who has been active in our community for 50 years. She is the host of Channel 9's show,
She's a long time
and yesterday, the International Women's Day Festival, and has been on the planning committee for 7 years. Among many groups, she has been involved in the AAUW, the Girl Scout Black Diamond Council, and the Athens City and Tri-County School Boards. Additionally, she has visited the United Nations headquarters in New York City under every Secretary General since 1949. With a presentation on Ohio's First Ladies, please welcome Lois Whaley.
And is Lois Whaley just like our late First Lady Nancy Reagan, EA, long A? This is the 100th anniversary of the national parks. And believe it or not, we have a national park right here in Ohio. It's up in Canton. And it is to the First Ladies, because Ohio has had 7 women who were First Ladies of the United States. The first one is Anna Sims Harrison. She was first for only 1 month because she never even made it to Washington, D.C.
Hero of the battle.
Her husband, William Henry, died within 1 month of taking office. Anna Sims Harrison. The next First Lady is Lucy Webb Hayes, the first First Lady who had a college education, 1876 to 1880. And she came from Chillicothe, Ohio, our neighboring city. Following Mrs. Hayes was Lucretia Randall.
She was only First Lady in 1881 because
you may remember that actually stayed around.
Was assassinated
almost 2 months. The grandson of William Henry Harrison was also president, and his wife was Mary McTeachers. Mostly showed these women as young women, not as we maybe often see them, rather older people. The next one, it's actually her former home that is part of the National Park First Presidential Ladies in Canton. Her name was Ida Saxton McKinley, and she was First Lady until 1901. Unfortunately, her husband was also assassinated, and that's how Theodore Roosevelt, who was Vice President, became President. Our next one is Helen Herron Taft, and she was from Cincinnati. She went to the 25th wedding anniversary of Mrs. Hayes. She thought, my husband's going to be the President of the United States sometime, and he was. And you know, he's the only president who also became the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. She and he had a good time in the Philippines because, remember, there was a war in 1898, which only lasted a couple of months, and then the United States got what was left of Spain's empire. Finally, we have Florence King, who actually defeated another Ohio in 1920 to become president of the United States, but President Harding died in office. Those are the seven First Ladies. Thank you.
Up next, my co-host, Monica, is going to spend time, and we're going to go back and revisit the challenges that women faced when it came to having the right to vote. It's going to be accompanied by a video screen presentation. So when it gives you cues for responses, don't be shy.
My name is Monica Hatfield Price, and I am a suffragist. Do you know that in this year, 1919, women still do not have the right to vote? Did you know that this is the time to speak up for women's vote, women's suffrage? Yeah! Do you know that we should fight for the things which we have always held nearest our hearts, for democracy, for the rights of those who submit to authority, to have a voice in their own government? Yeah!
As soon as I was released from prison, I marched with 25 women
in New York City, where the president was visiting before going overseas. 200 policemen greeted us with unbelievable ferocity. They beat us back with their clubs with such cruelty. The police seized us, broke our poles, some of them over our backs, trampled our pennants, pounded and dragged us. They should be ashamed to beat American women in this brutal way. If we were breaking the law, I said, arrest us. Do not beat us in this cowardly fashion. Six of us were arrested, but in half an hour, we were all free. I returned to my comrades afterwards, but the police broke up our meeting, and a man hit me on the side of the head with heavy banner pole. My hat was snatched from my head and burned on the street. Newspaper headlines will read, 200 maddened women try to see the president. 200 women attack the police.
Their subjection.
They will ultimately secure for themselves equal power and responsibility in whatever system of government is evolved is certain. How revolutionary will be the changes when women get this power and responsibility? One cannot adequately foretell. However, they will not go back. They will never again be good and willing slaves. Women must depend upon themselves to get equality. No group in the community with lesser rights was ever given liberty by those who had greater power. When all suffrage controversy has died away, it will be the little army of women with their purple, white, and gold banners going to prison for their political freedom that will be remembered. Yeah! Yeah! The challenge of the picket lines. And violent enemies. Will you join me to the absent sweep of indifference? Women to stand zealous friends in themselves, in their own judgments. Be self-respecting enough to put your freedom first and to determine on this day that you should be free.
Next up, we have Brenna Innocenzi. She is a student studying exercise psychology. She writes her own original songs that focus on inspiring women and girls by exploring themes of confidence and individuality. That she wants to encourage women to defy society, not for others, defy society's expectations for themselves. To the stage is Brenna.
So, as you said, my name is Brenna, and I'm a songwriter. Something that all women can relate to. We are complimented by being told that we're pretty. And while that's a nice thing to say, it doesn't really say anything about who we are and what we accomplish. This is a song that I wrote that is supposed to emphasize my discontent with that fact. Just being pretty does not measure my self-worth. It doesn't really tell you anything about me. This song is called Pretty Girls, and I hope you guys like it.
This world was meant for pretty girls. No room for anything other than that. This world was meant for foolishness. Ignorance is bliss. Ignorance is bliss. Who cares what she knows as long as she's got nice clothes, best dressed. It's popularity contest. To be successful, you gotta give up your success. It's those dispositions and psychology, society and biology. They all screw us over. They all suck. And so they bid on me at the auction. Independence is not an option. And praise will that is so empty. Don't stop at my face when you look at me. They think they are complimenting me. They say I'm pretty. I stood up and tried to prove myself. If I laugh, they laugh harder. They don't care, even if I prove. that I am smarter. I wanted to scoop out the media for so long. They paint a picture, got all the major details wrong. I am more than the color of my hair. I am more than the underwear that I wear. I am not just another lonely girl in the world, and I bet you she isn't either.
Nothing to do with books. Thank you.
Your lyrics are beautiful and your voice is pretty. Now that we've had a little voice and a little music to get us rhyming, we've got a next performance for you that is a dance-based performance by the members of the Latino and Hispanic Student Association, choreographed by none other than Dr. Alicia Chavarra Prado of the Office of Diversity and Inclusion.
In the beautiful Mexican coastal region of the state of Veracruz, feminine beauty holds a spiritual power that is both feared and revered. This power is personified in the nightly flight of La Bruja.
I'm
contemporary dancers performing to the song Beautiful.
Lost hope, I was all alone. Never been so long till you came. All in a rush, rush. Thank you.
Fujiwara, Alana Gibson, and Lisa Smith. I want to acknowledge their hard work and courage in preparing to dance for you today. Welcome.
Thank you.
organization is excited to perform in celebration of International Women's Day.
Alisa Martinez. Alisa is a student in media studies and art.
It means life isn't easy.
Siempre necesitas.
Thank you.